Yeah.
Wizard Nation!
Yeah! Hey Wizards,
I'm Kate.
And I'm Evan.
Welcome to this feature episode of BGTV, where we'll be covering events that happened in the school and in the Washington community.
This episode will cover highlights from the eSports event, the Faculty Flag football game, the Cancer Club, including Movember, and the Turkey Trot.
Wow, we've got a lot of really great stuff this week.
Yep, so let's jump right in. The eSports event, Project Extra Life, was held at the high school the Friday before Thanksgiving break.
It seemed like so much fun.
Yeah, I really wish I was able to go. But thank you to everyone who came out to support. Now let's go to Andrea for the coverage on the event and words from Tyler Warren, Edward Honan, and Mr. Connolly.
Hello, I'm Andrea, and I'm coming to you from Washingtonville High School talking about eSports Project Extra Life. And I'm here with Tyler Warren. Are you excited for this?
I'm very excited.
Are you excited for this night?
Yeah, I think it's a great night. It's a great night for our kids to get together and do something they enjoy and at the same time raise some money for a good cause.
And we're here with
Edward Honan.
Hello, Edward. And what do you think eSports is?
I think eSports is basically just having a fun time trying to help people in need with a family that has an illness.
Would you like this event to happen again next year?
Yeah, that'd be fun.
Thank you, back to you.
There was a faculty flag football game the Tuesday before Thanksgiving break. It was organized with Mr. Clow as a means of camaraderie. It was held at Borden's Field across from the high school. The coaches were Mr. Clow with the team Red Wing Militia and Mrs. Serrar with the team Back That Pass Up. It ended with a win for the Red Wing Militia.
It was so much fun to watch. Did you see those great touchdowns by Mr. LePere, Mr. Bruschino, and Ms. Burling Powers?
Yeah, it was great. Let's turn to Jacob with the coverage.
On November 25th, a group of Washingtonville teachers played a faculty football game. The teams were the Red Wing Militia in red and Back That Pass Up in green. The game was extremely competitive for Mr. Clow and Ms. Serrar.
Okay, so year by year, I managed to beat Ms. Serrar, so we like to find contests where she can possibly win.
This is Jacob Woods reporting live with Coach Clow, one of the coaches for the faculty flag game. Coach, how do you feel your team is going to produce this week?
Top to bottom, we're strong. We're real strong. We got a lot of guys who know what their role is and are going to perform that role for us, okay? One synced unit working together, okay, to get victory.
How do you feel your team chemistry is going to be?
Great chemistry. Great chemistry. You know, you look at the people I chose a lot. I really stayed in this hallway, especially the Red Wing here. We got, you know, Mr. Bruschino, first-round draft pick, Ms. BP, Bearling Powers, Mr. Wargo, Ms. Carnwright. You know, we really try to keep it in the family here, okay? And that's what we're doing with this team. We're a family, okay? When we were drafted, we became a family, a unit, okay? And that's what we did.
This was one of five touchdowns for Mr. Clow and his stellar performance. Mr. LePere and Mr. Bruschino were a big part as they combined for four touchdowns. Here are some of Mr. Bruschino's and Ms. Serrar's thoughts before the game on the draft.
Clow's team, how does it feel to be drafted first?
I'm honored. I'm honored that Mr. Clow chose me as the first pick. I mean, I'm going to do everything I can to help the team. It's all about the team.
Do not tackle me.
I will not tackle
you. Do not tackle
me. How do you think your team stacks up to Coach Clow's?
I think we're going to dominate. I think we're going to beat him. He has a very large head. He seems to think he's always going to win. So we are going to defeat him this time, deflate his big head, and we will be good to go.
The Red Wing Militia won 7-4. Both teams look to do another event sometime in the future. Thanks to Evan and Kate. Back to you guys in the studio.
Let's switch it over to Ray Gonzalez with information about the Movember campaign.
Cancer Club meets every week on Tuesdays in room 122. Cancer Club supports the Movember campaign, which ended last week. Thank you to all those who participated in raising awareness of men's prostate cancer. If you wish to help raise awareness of any kind of cancer, please feel free to contact Ms. Lynch in room 122, or contact Lucia Dugan as well. And here's Ms. Lynch with more about the Cancer Club.
How did the Wizard vs. Cancer Club start?
The Wizards vs. Cancer Club, or Wizards Against Cancer, began as a brainchild of Lucia Dugan, who is a 12th grader here at Washingtonville. She was really passionate to kind of make a change in our school and also bring about a really great support group. We definitely raise funds for cancer research. It's not just about awareness. I know we do our color days to really raise awareness, but in October, we sold shirts and sold bracelets, thanks to Richie Cipher, to raise money for the American Cancer Society and the Making Strides Against Breast Cancer events. We raised close to, or actually over, I think it is $1,000 for that. And so we're looking to move forward with a middle school dance, as well as possibly bringing a cancer walk-a-thon to the high school, where all those proceeds will go directly to kids and teens that are battling cancer here in Orange County.
The turkey trot that was scheduled to be held on Thanksgiving was unfortunately canceled due to the fairly large amount of snow we received the day before.
Dang it.
Yeah, I was sorry to hear it.
Thanks for tuning in to this week's feature episode. Hope you enjoyed.
See you soon.
Hashtag Wizard Nation.